Lord Megatron 27 here, doing a Transformers Universe 2.0 of Sunstreaker. Sorry. Alright, this is a very nice Transformer, one of my favorites from the Universe series. You'll notice first off that he has his traditional scoops on his roof, and on his license plate, let's see, you can see it on there, it says We Are 84. Very nice. One thing you'll notice about this car when you get him is that his color of yellow is not as vibrant as the original, but that's okay. Mainly up here in the roof, where it's very thin and you can almost see through it. I don't know if you can see it on the TV, on the screen there, but you can see a lot of black coming through that yellow. That's okay. His gun, which was already underneath there but fell out, sticks underneath his vehicle form, if it stay up there for me, and does form his exhaust tips, as you can see right there, which is kind of a cool little deal with them. Gives you somewhere to store it, as long as it doesn't fall out. If you tap on it a few times, or even just kind of brush it, it will fall right out. So I'll set that aside for right now. He is quite a nice guy. Another one that looks just like him, only in red, Sideswipe, which Transformers are just a tad bit different, mainly because the hands on the guys are switched, so his roof becomes his chest and Sideswipe's hood becomes his chest. But you can switch the hands around and make them the opposite. We can have a yellow, you know, Sideswipe and a red Sunstreaker, but you know, who's gonna do that? Anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and go into the Transform here. One thing I am glad about the Sunstreaker, they did make him a Lamborghini, which is very, very nice, seeing how he was a Lamborghini G1. I do not have a G1 Sunstreaker. I wish I did. I do have a G1 Sideswipe, but I don't have a Sunstreaker. Anyway, this piece will pop off the roof, and the first time transforming this guy is a very, very difficult task. He's kind of a tough one to transform. So you just gotta take your time with him, but you will have him transformed. Alright, first thing you're gonna do is you're gonna extend his rear tail lamps out like that, and just kind of push him to the side. Alright, both of them right there, just push him to the side. Now, what you're gonna do at this point is you need to get him to start to separate. And like I said, he is a tricky transformer, so just bear with me, guys. Getting him to separate is the biggest issue with him being in his transform mode. Sometimes you gotta work with him and fight with him a little bit, but he will transform. Just give me a second here. I get his doors and legs to separate. I'm gonna show you since I get him to separate there. Now what you're gonna do is you're just kinda break them apart like that. Alright, you can see that. And I take them apart. Then you can flip his legs around. Alright. Just flip his legs around. Flip them. And then he does have, his feet are tucked underneath here. If you can get him to release his dang feet, which sometimes can be a task in itself. We'll come back to his feet. We'll go to his upper body first, and we'll come back to his feet. Alright, what you're going to do is twist his arms out like that, and this extends up. Alright. Extends up and back. Now he'll do a rotation motion like this. Alright, and what you're gonna do is you're gonna twist his chest piece that way, and his head will pop up. And then you can take his hands, swing the doors back like that. Swing the doors back. Get his feet in the position you want him to be in. Go back to his feet. And now, see what happened here is his foot's on a ball joint and it will pop off. If it falls off, it's okay. Just pop back on. Around. Now, these little pieces here, some people will do them, let me turn around so I can see what I'm doing. Some people will swing them off to the side and they will pop off the ball joint. And I want to say it goes like that. He has a lot of articulation, you will notice that about him. Once you get him actually in the area you want him, get him to stay there. His legs are kind of shit, because they're kind of bulky looking, if you want to take a look at him like that. He's kind of bulky. And there's one thing about this, but his upper body is awesome. He has a very great upper body. Alright. That fixes his arm. Oh no, his arm popped off. That's okay. Once again, curse the ball joint on these guys. The ball joints do like to show their ass and fall off a lot. That's alright. See what I mean? Every one of these guys, man, the ball joints just, they just pop off, but that's alright. Keeps us reviewers on our toes. Anyway. There he is, in all his glory. He can't twist his head around, make his head do things. It will move. His little ear deals do move back and forth. But technically, that's him. He's a good bot. He looks good, except for his legs. I don't like the bottom. I don't know how like how wide his legs are. I think they look kind of cheesy like that, but that's okay. The rear panel for his tail lamps and stuff do not click in anymore, so they just float around loosely. Other than that, I mean, he is a great bot. Now you can, if you switch him around, okay, I'll kind of do a quick little deal here. All you gotta do is switch his arms around and twist this part back around this way. And then you can have his, you know, his hood as his chest. But you want to stick to the iconic look of him and keep him like that. All in all, he's a great bot. If 5 out of 10 stars, I'd have to give him probably about a 9.5. He's a good looking guy. Anyway, this is Lord Megatron 27 signing off. Till next time, when I will do a 2.0 version of Prowl. And Lord Megatron 27 signing off till next time. See you later.